Did you know there are two originally dark-skinned populations who organically mutated medium brown skin, ranging from golden brown to high yellow? And the opposite is true for some Southeast Asian groups, who originally had fairer skin but later repigmented into medium brown tones. But here's the real question. Why do so many desert populations living in the hottest, sun-scorched regions of the world have moderately melanated light brown skin? Isn't melanin supposed to protect us from harsh sunlight? Or do these people somehow have a cheat code against the sun? Well, medium brown skin is full of surprises, and it's not what you think. As I mentioned in my previous videos, we've already explored why dark skin populations exist and why others became depigmented over time. Now, it's time to talk about those in between, the medium browns, the caramels, the pardos, the brown mention, the in-betweeners of human pigmentation. As you know, brown skin in general is often associated with South Asians, since most of them fall somewhere on the spectrum. But if we step outside social constructs, medium brown skin is actually the most universal human tone. It appears in every major racial group and in every continent, even among Europeans. But unlike darker or lighter tones, medium brown skin has multiple origin stories. Some populations evolve it naturally as a balance between protection from the sun and vitamin D production. Groups like the Highland Papuans and some Solomon Island Melanesians develop lighter skin through unique genetic changes. Specifically, mutations in the gene like OCA2 and MFSD12. Meanwhile, the Khoisan people also develop medium brown skin organically, partly through ancient contact with Cushitic groups who carried the SLC24A5 gene. Although those Cushitic ancestors had darker skin due to living closer to the equator, when their genes mixed with southern African populations in lower UV environments, natural selection favors slightly lighter tones for better vitamin D absorption. While other populations reach medium brown skin through complex genetic mixing. This happens among North Africans, West Asians, and South Asians, whose ancient ancestors such as the Basal Eurasians, Natufians, Zagrosians, and Ibero-Merusians were originally darker. And over time, they mixed with Anatolian farmers who had evolved lighter skin through the mutation of SLC24A5, driven by low sunlight and grain-based diet. These Neolithic migrations and admixtures explain why many desert populations today, like Arabians, Iranics, Levantines, Berbers, and Egyptians, have skin ranging from medium brown to fair. A similar story, though, involving different genes occurred in South Asia. The Indo-Aryans, who carried lighter skin genes like KITLG, mixed with the darker Dravidian populations of the ancient Indus Valley, and over thousands of years, their ancestries fused, creating the diverse range of golden and brown tones seen across the region today. And later in history, colonial-era mixing added more layers of brown skin diversity. Groups like Cape Coloreds, Cape Verdeans, Dominicans, and Brazilian Pardos, to name a few, emerged from global blending of African, European, and indigenous ancestries, producing many new shades of brown across continents. And finally, there are the redarkening of once light populations. Some groups that lived for long periods in cooler, low UV environments later moved into sunny regions and evolved darker skin again, a process called repigmentation. This happened among tropical Amerindians and some Southeast Asian peoples. So, this shows us human skin can adapt in both ways, depending on where life takes us. Now, let's explore its many shades, starting from the darkest as we move gradually to the lightest. Let's start with honey brown, a shade lighter than golden bronze, the lightest shade from my previous dark skin video, also called by African Americans red bone. It's smooth, warm, and amber-like, a radiant tone that often appears among light-skinned Africans and their descendants. Under the sun, it glows with a copper-golden warmth, almost like liquid sunlight reflecting on skin. Scientifically, this tone forms when melanin levels are moderately reduced, allowing yellow and red undertones to shine through without fully losing their protective pigment. It is a delicate balance between strength and radiance. Melanin that still protects, but also let the skin beam with light. In Africa, honey brown is found in small percentages among many sub-Saharan groups, from the Yorubas, Igbos and Ashantis in the west, to the Taitas, Sandawe, Swahili, Kikuyus and Kambas in the east, and among southern Bantu people such as the Xhosa, Sotho and Swana. Beyond Africa, this color blooms in the Afro-diaspora, among African Americans, Afro-Brazilians, Afro-Iranians, Sindhis and Afro-Arabs, each carrying traces of ancestral sunlight in their skin. Honey brown is not just a tone, it's a soft glow of resilience and warmth, a living memory of Africa's golden light. A shade lighter but still richer is caramel brown, sometimes called medium red skin. This tone sits beautifully between golden and reddish hues, with a soft neutral warmth that changes with light. Under daylight, it looks golden tan. Under shade, it deepens into a reddish glow. Scientifically, this tone reflects balanced melanin with subtle blood pigments, producing that luminous caramel effect. It evolves in both hot savannas and shaded woodlands, climates that need protection from the sun without sacrificing vitamin D absorption. In Africa, it appears among the Kalahari Sun, Ethiosemites, Sudanese Arabs, and Mauritanian Moors. Across the ocean, it's common among Central and South American natives, the descendants of the Aztec, Mayan, Sonoran, and Amazonian peoples. In Asia, it shines throughout South Asia, from India to Bangladesh to Sri Lanka, and among Cambodians, and in smaller percentages among Malays, Filipinos, and Indonesians. In Oceania, it also softens the skin of some Melanesian and Polynesian groups. Caramel brown is the color of sunlight filtered through forest leaves, gentle, adaptive, and beautifully balanced between gold and red. A shade lighter is golden brown, the color of morning sun on sand, a bright golden tone that turns almost bright yellow under sunlight. With strong yellow undertones, it represents the truest form of gold skin among humans. Scientifically, this tone forms where melanin is low but not absent, creating a semi-translucent glow that radiates warmth and softness. In Africa, its purest form is found among Khoisan peoples, from the extinct strand loopers to modern groups like the Nama, Komani, and Korana. These people, living in semi-arid desert with strong sunlight but cool air and low UV, evolved this tone as a perfect balance of protection and vitamin D absorption. It also appears, though rarely, among some highland Papuans and Solomon Islanders. Golden brown skin is a natural masterpiece, the Earth's own golden hour, preserved in human form. Then comes olive brown, also known as tawny brown, a medium tone with a soft greenish, grayish, or yellow-gold undertone, depending on the light. Under the sun, it can shift from muted bronze to glowing gold. Scientifically, it's the result of moderate eumelanin combined with subtle pheomelanin and keratin, creating that earthy olive tint in certain lighting. This color comes from both admixture and also organically evolved in regions where sunlight was bright but the climate varied, deserts, coasts, and mountain ranges. In Africa, it's common among Egyptians, Siwa Berbers, Tuaregs, Mauritanian Moors, and Mozabite Berbers. In East Africa, it appears among the Barawas, but also found in low numbers among Sudanese Arabs, Swahili people, and Ethiosemitic groups. In West Africa, it shines among mixed Afro-Portuguese people, known as Luso Africans of Cape Verde, and comes in low numbers among mixed Afro-Arabs like the Shua Arabs and the Fulani people, while in South Africa, it appears among the Khalals and Gofals. In Asia, this tone is dominant among Peninsula Arabs from the Hejaz to Oman to Yemen and the Gulf, and also appears as the second majority tone among Levantines, Mesopotamians, and Iranics. In South Asia, it dominates among Pakistanis, Northwest Indians, and some Bengalis. Even in Europe, traces appears among Southern Mediterraneans, but in very low numbers, among Sicilians, Maltese, and Greeks, and also found among Romanis all over Europe. And across the Atlantic, it is common among Andean and Patagonian natives. In Oceania, it is found among many Polynesians from Hawaii to New Zealand. Olive brown is one of humanity's most widespread and adaptable tones, a true bridge between continents, climates, and cultures. Finally, we reach high yellow, or yellow bone as the African Americans call it. It's the lightest shade of medium brown, glowing with strong yellow undertones. Under sunlight, it radiates a soft golden shimmer. This is the truest representation of yellow skin among humans. Scientifically, it comes from minimum eumelanin with abundant pheomelanin combined with keratin, giving that buttery warmth without losing pigmentation entirely. In Africa, this tone appears among some Khoi peoples, and in higher numbers among mixed Afro-Europeans, groups like Cape Coloureds, Rehoboth Bastards, Griquas, Orlams, and Luso Africans. Across Asia, it is found among Austronesian and Austroasiatic peoples, from Northeast India, Myanmar, and Bhutan, to Thailand, Malaysia, and Indonesia, and among South Sinid populations in Vietnam and Southern China. In the Americas, this shade shined among mixed Afro-Europeans, from the Pardos to Euro-Caribbeans like Dominicans, to the light-skinned African-Americans where the name yellow bone becomes a cultural term for the light golden skin. This tone is living sunlight, gentle, bright, and full of warmth. So guys, there you have it, the radiant spectrum of medium brown skin. If you enjoyed this journey through golden tones, check out my previous videos where I explore all shades of dark skin and fair skin and how abundant or lack of melanin shaped our evolution. And as always, stay curious, stay smart, and thank you very much for watching.